I must be careful now.
Blood eagle!
Jet, need to get on the other side.
Jack! Dead like dog!
This is it on such cowardice. Keep focused! Guard up! Going to suffer!
You archer dog! Cram in! Leave no room! Even little hits next to
you! Kill you! In for the kill!
Ah!
Must be black from the other side. Be my eyes, Sunan.
Be careful, or be cursed! Foul magic!
What is this menace you shout about? Is it some creature you hunt?
My prey is the most cunning of beasts, capable of vile deeds beyond the ability of any common animal.
You're hunting someone, then?
A warlock. One who once called himself a man, but has since befouled his hugur, his whole being, with twisted Seidr magic.
This has the feel of something more personal.
The evil spider who squats in yonder hut poisoned my own sister. For that alone, it deserves to die. But maybe you would be moved to help by the bounty King Harald has offered for any warlock killed.
Profit can persuade where passion fails. I'll weigh this against the effort.
The warlock makes its lair down this road to the left. Keep an eye out.
Have you come to face me, finally? Or will you continue to harass me from afar?
Are you the warlock who laid a curse on this land?
There was a curse here long before I came along. A curse of ignorance that infects all of Midgard.
So you are not using your magic against this land and its people?
I try to use my knowledge to help others. I am only a threat to those who fear the unknown, of which there are many.
There is a hunter who believes you poisoned his sister.
I tried to save her. I made a mixture that would have burned away her illness, but he chose to drench her in pig's blood. If there is any blame here, it lies on him and his ignorant kin. He killed his sister.
Do not listen. He will poison our folks.
You have no thoughts to poison.
Die, monster!
Hell with you!
One day, this land will be cleansed of these twisted deceivers. I struck first, so I will claim the bounty. You may take what you wish from its carcass.
Blood freezes. Best not to draw attention here.
Back! Hey! Get them now!
Got you! Yeah.
not good.
Shit, get away from me!
The other side must be barred. go, Sunan. I need your eyes, my friend.
Þessi Kristfríður er drafl. Muni dreja tós í þúsundum.
Yeah!
Let the sail out! Show me.
Close the oars! No sail!
Head for the dock! Feeder of ravens returns, and not half dead. We thought we had lost you, Eivor, for good this time. A warm welcome as always, Ranvi. You look like reddened sheet. What happened? Nothing to crow about, except to say the men who delayed us are dead. And how are you? Well enough, though I have spent many tiresome days calming the rages of our king. He is not happy with you. I expected as much. And what of Sigurd? Has he returned from his raids? My husband should be home today. The last we heard, he was approaching Stavanger. Good to hear. We have need of his courage.
Sigurd will not save you from his father's wrath, Eivor. You should know that by now.
Did your raid not go as planned? They rarely go as planned. But we killed many of Kjotve's warriors. And there was this. My father's axe among the dead. Ah. After so many years. You should take it to Gunnar. He will give it back its edge. A good idea. After I see our king. That I do not advise. Not yet. He is meeting with a messenger from the north. I can wait. A cloud hangs over you. Is something wrong? Seeing my father's axe after 17 winters. It stirred something in me. A feeling I have not had since. Since the day he was killed. Since the day I got this. Memories of past agonies. Of sadness and pain. I should speak with Valka. She could help me make sense of my feelings.
Take your time getting settled. I will see you at the Longhouse.
I think you have lost your edge, Eivor. Just like that axe. Maybe Gunnar can help you with both.
I will let you know. Tovi, trading a needle for an arrow, I see.
Eivor, can you teach me the art of archery?
I'll be happy to. See how I'm standing? Plant your feet in the ground, no wider than your shoulders. Breathe in as you draw the arrow back. Look at the point you want to hit, and now imagine the arrow passing straight through it and far beyond. Breathe out, then release.
Thank you, Eivor. Now, I have something for you.
See? All in the eye.
Thank you, Eivor. As a gift, I could design a new tattoo for you. Something to decorate your scar.
A kind offer. I want this scar visible.
Oh, I did not mean to offend. In any case, I do have a tattoo for you.
Survey the area, Sunan.
Can I interest you in a game of Orlok?
Orlok. There is a player in every port and city.
Orlok. A game of skill. Orlok. How about a game?
Let us play.
I am pretty good. Do not say I did not warn you.
This will do.
This game is as good as over. Interesting.
Luck is with you this time.
Are you going to walk away now with your head hung in defeat? Let us play again.
I've had enough of this.
Hey, Hjarta!
Have it out there.
Caught anything?
Not today. The fish aren't biting. Too many passing boats churning the water.
I lack the patience for pole fishing. I would have better luck with my bow.
Shooting fish with a bow? That could work.
Caught anything?
Not today.
I lack the patience for pole...
Shooting fish with... Hello, Eivor.
Well, look who it is.
Practicing your wordplay, Alvis.
Ah, Eivor! The only mouth in Midgard from which I fear mockery.
You taught me the art of writing poetry, old friend. It is only natural that I surpass you soon.
How about another lesson, then? A quick flight. Right here, right now. What do you say?
Let's try flighting.
I always put a few coins down as a wager. Most of those who enjoy flighting have an equal fondness for betting. But today, we'll abstain. Let me begin.
I'm ready.
In flighting, it's key to match cadence and rhyme. It's as much about sound as it is about time. So be careful in choosing the words that you say.
With your teachings, I'm sure my next challenger I will slay.
No. The rhyme is good, but too many words upsets the rhythm. Now, let us examine meaning. In flighting, you'll need to be cutting and keen. It's about wielding wit more than venting your spleen. If I tell you you're foolish and stupid and dull...
Then I will make a fine goblet from out of your skull.
Not bad, not bad. The rhyme is there, the sound is good, but... Consider that I said you were silly, and you told me you would kill me. At times, it might be best to remain on theme. Something to consider. Last one. So go, then, and conquer the world with your wit. Go be clever, be quick, show your spirit and grit. I look eagerly forward to seeing how you fare.
I will make you regret what you've taught me today.
I haven't taught you enough if you think that line works. Where's the rhyme? There's still much for you to learn about flighting, but I'm confident you'll pick it up. Happy to help you learn, if you'd like to come back again.
Perhaps I will. Thank you, Alvis.
Eivor!
Good day, Alvis.
You return! Would you like to try again?
I would. It may be I'll fare better this time.
I believe in you!
Let's try flighting.
I always put a few coins down as a wager. Most of those who enjoy flighting have an equal fondness for betting. But today, we'll abstain. Let me begin.
I'm ready.
In flighting, it's key to match cadence and rhyme. It's as much about sound as it is about time. So be careful in choosing the words that you say.
I'll recall what you taught ere I enter the fray.
A fine answer! Perfect rhyme and a lovely cadence to match my line. Now, let us examine meaning. In flighting, you'll need to be cutting and keen. It's about wielding wit more than venting your spleen. If I tell you you're foolish and stupid and dull...
Then I tell you you've nothing inside of your skull.
A good response. I called you stupid and you turned it around. Flighting about wit, you matched my meaning. When you think of too many perfect retorts, use the one that best matches the meaning. Last one. So go then and conquer the world with your wit. Go be clever, be quick, show your spirit and grit. I look eagerly forward to seeing how you fare.
I look forward to becoming far more than you can bear.
A good rhyme, but a bad structure. Close, you're close. Your flighting's astounding, you're worthy of praise. You swing a fine axe and you turn a good phrase.
Thank you, Alvis. I'll take the lesson to heart. Hey, can you point me to some good hunting grounds?
I could, but I don't want every iron foot with a bow scaring away the game. Bring me 3 deer antlers to prove your skills, and I might just have a story for you.
A worthy challenge. I'll see you soon.
Eivor, Wolfkist, welcome back.
Gunnar, I have something here you might like to see.
Thunderclap of Thor! Is that your father's axe? I have not seen this beauty since, well, for some time. I forged this weapon long ago. Still looks good. One of my finest, I think.
It has a blunted blade, but it swings well. Can you sharpen it?
I can give it a better edge and reinforce the handle. And as luck would have it, I have one ingot left for the job.
Are you sure?
The fates have willed it so. But in future, bring your own metal ingots. I cannot forge them from empty air. That should do it. Anything else? Do you need anything else?
That is all for now.
Return any time.
Would like to hear a story. Who
this
would enjoy a tale of the gods?
While clan battles clan.
There has always been war, even among the gods. When Midgard was young, Asgard strife. The battle-born Asir.
Hey, Tekla. What is brewing?
Alvis tells me this brew is too strong. Think you can handle a few rounds?
The battle-born Asir hated the man's magic, betrayed customs, and made murder in Odin's great hall. Two men of the man was killed. once, but three times. And reborn this mother of the vault, the war that came after. Could outdrink every one of you. Don't feel bad. Most of these backgrounds would have pissed themselves or passed by now. Come and drink. Let us amuse the gods.
All right, Tekla. I'll outdrink you. Hey, Tekla. What is brewing?
Alvis tells me. Outdrink every one of you. Don't feel bad. Most of these backgrounds would have pissed themselves or passed by now.
Sven, have you designed any new tattoos?
A few worth looking at?
Tove says she's trying out some new tattoos.
She is, and she's getting better at it.
Let me have a look.
Go ahead. Good. Need anything else?
Let me have a look.
Go ahead. Is there something else?
See you later, Sven.
Sure.
They must be finished now. But if you have any other business, it may be wise to do it now. Let him cool down. I could speak to Volka first. Get this weight off my mind. The king is not going anywhere.
Hey! Hamuram. Hamuram.
Volka?
Hush. I need silence to hear the songs of nature. Hamuram. Hamuram.
Svala.
She gives praises and she is greeted.
For your hearing, I hearken. O ancient ones, great Odin, great Freya, I give you thanks for your gift of Seidr.
She gives thanks and she is blessed.
Eivor, it has been some time. What brings you so far to see me?
I have come for your advice on a private matter.
Come.
Is your mother well?
Her mind is a jumble. She speaks to spirits. I fear her final winter has come, but she has me. Now, let us speak to your needs.
I have had a vision. A powerful vision. It may have been my battle lust, or a delirium caused by the cold, but...
Describe it for me.
After 17 years, I saw my father's axe again. And when I touched it, the vision came on fast. There was a wolf, howling and fierce. And then a figure. A greybeard in a cloak. With a single eye. He bid me follow him.
Ah, the High One. He calls to you. Perhaps he means to speak with you. Deliver a message. Only through Seidr will you see more clearly, and unravel the threads that sit tangled upon your mind. This will not take long.
What are you brewing?
An elixir to loosen your hugur and unwind your thoughts. You will enter a waking sleep, and journey to the world of dreams. It may confuse or disorient you, but you must take note of all you see. Drink. If you seek true understanding.
I saw nothing, Volka. Felt nothing. Harvey! Harvey. Harvey! Why walk among the dead? Sigurd. Sigurd! Brother! When did you arrive? Brother! What is this?
There was no other way, Javi. Our fates are fixed.
Take it! What has happened?
This was not for you, Javi.
No!
Steady, Eivor. It is Valka. I am here.
God! I thought I... What was that?
Tell me everything.
I was on a mountain, in a violent blizzard, climbing toward the summit, following a wolf.
Mm-hmm.
I saw Odin and the Nornir spinning the threads of fate. They were watching me.
Not watching. They were showing you the way forward. Your life, your path, what lies before you, and where it ends.
And the wolf was eager for my attention, as if it were beckoning me to follow.
You are the Wolfkist, fated to carry its mark for life. In this case, it might represent your ambition, or your fear.
I saw the gates to Odin's Hall of Slain Champions. They opened for me.
Shades of Valhalla, for which you are destined.
I do not know what else to say. My memories are faint, hazy.
Did you reach the summit of this mountain?
I did, yes. Sigurd was there, wounded, in pain. His fighting arm was missing. Then the wolf reappeared, the size of a dragon, twisted and terrible. It fixed its eyes on me and struck. Then I woke.
The gods favor you, Eivor. They always have. You will have your glory, and you will earn your place in Valhalla. But these portents carry a darker truth. The missing arm, the trail of blood, the beast. You will betray your brother, Sigurd. That is the meaning of your vision.
That cannot be right. I would never betray Sigurd. He's my brother, my family.
The Nornir have spoken, and this is their message.
No, this is wrong, or you misunderstand. That cannot be right.
You will betray Sigurd.
Odin fought against his fate. It can be done.
Yeah. Huh? So, Iman is asleep on his watch. That would explain some things.
Iman! Wake up, or you'll be cast into the wild.
Must stay awake. They could be anywhere.
Is he walking in his sleep?
Die, everyone dies. Must not fall asleep. Need to see them coming.
Ivan, wake up! You're headed for the edge!
Is he going to ride the rope slide?
Windy. Storm coming. What?
Ivan! Ivan! Calm down. You are asleep.
No! I was flying through the air!
In your sleep. A harsh awakening, true. But at least you live. Have you always taken these dream walks?
Since my posting here. When I am in bed, I worry about ways we could be attacked. When I'm on watch, I cannot stay awake.
Only a fool stays awake all night worrying. You're tired when you get up, and the problem is still not solved.
You speak with the wisdom of Odin, Eivor. I will think on these words when I am in bed.
Consider them on your watch, and sleep when in your bed. But now, report back before you're labeled a deserter. Go! Yeah.
Thank you.
Is there no one who will go around with me?
They must be finished now.
The king has called for his best mead, so the talks are concluded. It should be safe to enter.
I'm ready to face the thunder. I'll speak with the king now.
Excellent, King Styrbjorn. I will take this proposal to my nephew. I believe he will see the wisdom in it.
Good. It is all I can hope for. May the... May the winds favor your voyage, Guthormr.
Eivor, come forward, and explain in plain words why you have willfully disobeyed my commands. Do you mock me?
I do not mock you, King. I mean to embolden you, against your enemies, and your own poor judgment.
You know nothing of my judgment. You know nothing of my plans and strategies.
Sigurd would agree with me.
My son might agree with you, but he would obey me. He knows his place.
Not as well as he knows his father.
Imagine you are harassed by an enemy with warriors that vastly outnumber your own. What profit does open war bring? Would it not be better to work quietly through diplomacy, gaining alliances? Waiting until the day our numbers outweigh our enemies and our victory is guaranteed.
Do we have any allies to speak of? Or is that your excuse to do nothing?
Your confidence blinds you to so much in plain sight, Eivor. Day and night I toil to forge ties with clans to the north. Very soon you will see the fruits of my efforts. Only then will you understand.
Is that all?
I'm at a loss with you, Eivor. When I took you in as my own, never did I imagine such disrespect from the child of Varin. Your father was a fine man. Just and loyal to me, he died bravely so that we might live.
He died a coward, Lord. A fate I will not mirror.
Why do you carry such a useless burden? Let it go! Think only of the days to come, of your future and the victories at hand.
My honor has been stained. Until it's wiped clean, I want nothing else.
I refuse to pick at that wound again. But if there is something that can chase these shadows from your thoughts...
Sigurd has come! Down at the docks, his ship is here!
Hey, careful with that one! Eivor!
Sigurd!
Ah, oh, look at you, blood-soaked drinker! What have you been worrying without me?
Ah, oh, and you, soul-cured Vikinger. I smell the stink of a dozen kingdoms in your beard.
It's just the start. Randvi, my dear wife. Your husband returns. Bringing gifts, and riches to share.
And new friends, I see.
Yes! Basim, and Hytham. We met in Miklagard, and they showed me her buried secrets.
We are grateful to Sigurd for his invitation, and eager to pay tribute to your king.
My brother is always very careful with the company he keeps, if you're standing safely beside him. He must like you.
Ah, Eivor. Save the introductions until our bellies are full. I will see my father. Tell him of my time away.
This morning we traded with a ship passing south. They told us Eivor the Wolf-Kissed was captured by Kjotve's men.
They must have cut the tale short. I killed my captors and recovered my crew. For that, your father scolded me. You know where I stand, brother. Nothing short of war will dislodge Kjotve from our lands. But he disagrees.
I know. I know. Father thinks too much and acts too little. Today that changes. I promise you. By the winter's end, the name Kjotve the Cruel will be a curse on the lips of a drunken fool.
My son! Welcome home!
Father!